The best kind of movies are the unexpected movies. Let's talk about this. What is up, Netflix fans? Welcome back to my channel. Today we are talking about the brand new Polish film that actually dropped yesterday. I'm a day late. It's called The Hater. Are you aware that this movie dropped on Netflix? And were you looking forward to it? Let's get into it. So this film is all about a young man who searches for a purpose in a net of hatred and violence that he tries to manipulate and control. This film is directed by Jan Komasa, and the character of Tomasz, that's where I want to start, is fascinating. He is just so secretively manipulative, and you find that out as we progress through the movie. A layered character, and one that you never actually know how he feels about a situation because of the fact that he is pretty much on every side within this film. It's the perfect example of the times that we're living in right now, showcasing this duplicitous character. It is also terrifying, knowing that there are those out here like this who are going to play it in public like they believe one thing, but secretly behind the scenes, we're actually doing everything that we could possibly do, using social media to ruin lives, to ruin campaigns for politicians. And sometimes, you know, the politicians aren't actually the best people. And we find that out as we progress through this movie. But there is a battle going on, really surrounding this young character who is just trying to find his place. And he's just trying to find where he belongs in life. He really wants to feel wanted and needed by certain characters in this film. And as we go, we just continue to see behind the scenes. And he's using a very interesting method of gathering this information that maybe they just they don't care about him as much as they tell him that they do. So because of that, he sets out on this path of overall destruction, but really self-destruction. Maybe he doesn't even know it. I love the visual cue in this film. As he gets deeper and deeper, he actually becomes more pale. It's like all of the life is leaving his body. He is emotionless by the end of the film. And again, not to those around him, but at his core, it's almost hollowed out. And we've seen these films dealing with, I want to say, psychopaths like this before, because that really is kind of what our character is. It reminds you of a recent movie in Nightcrawler, very different tactics that he's using. And I love the fact that we are keeping it super modern. He's utilizing social media, aka Facebook, but also someone like a Patrick Bateman, someone who is suppressing these ideas and these motivations like a Joker. I mean, you could name a lot of movie socio and psychopaths, right? But at the end of the day, this is a very different kind of story. But what our character doesn't know is the fact that his actions not only have virtual repercussions, but real life repercussions. And when we hit that scene, that moment, or these moments at the end of the film, it does indeed feel like all of our waiting on something like that is worth it, even though at the same time, it's extremely tragic and kind of gut-wrenching. So just so you all know, there will be a time in the third act where you're just on the edge of your seat completely, and it may seem shocking, but there are no actions that go unpunished. Right? So that is the interesting question answered by the end of the film. In terms of criticisms, I do think the movie, the runtime is an issue here, the length. Now, I will say that there is this fascinating connection with this unstable character that is formed, and it allows the audience to get past the fact that the movie is overlong and get past these pacing issues. But for the most part, I do think pacing is a problem. I also believe there were just one too many scenes where we stayed on a bit too long. I love the techniques of actually staying on our characters' faces and using camera movements to give us emotions. It's a really well-made film. There were just moments that made me sit back and say, I think this could have been executed a bit better. Still, even past that critique, I was surprised with The Hater. I did not know this was going to be as good as it was. Again, a few issues. It could have been better, but I like this movie quite a bit. It's a huge recommendation on Netflix. Thank you guys for watching this video. Before I give you my score, stay tuned because we have plenty more Netflix content this weekend and next week. I'm going to go a 72% for The Hater. It is a movie, like I said, that is worth watching. Polish film. You can do subbing or dubbing. I believed I'd do the subs. You guys are the best. Appreciate you for watching. I'll see you soon.